welcome everybody to the very first episode of the brand new Mascola Money podcast as part of our new SMS channel, What's Up Wednesdays, Suffern Middle School podcast. So check out the YouTube channel, subscribe. I will be putting out a podcast every Wednesday from now on with different power rankings of top five categories of my choosing for that week, varying in all different sorts of categories and selections and ranges. The other students in the podcast club will also be submitting different shows of their liking as well. So that should be a fun thing to get started here. So let's not wait anymore. Here they are, your power rankings for the week. Mascola Money Podcast, top five power rankings of the week.
It's time!
Let's get this list started. Today's countdown is top five non-religious American holidays. Let's get to number five.
Five.
So number five is almost number five out of the virtue, purely because it's technically not a holiday, but we're going with your birthday. Your birthday is number five on the list this week. Your birthday is a day that everybody loves. Everybody wants to celebrate. People give you gifts. You get to have one every year on your own unique special day, so it's not necessarily something that gets tied into a celebration for other people. You get to feel like the attention is on you for a little bit, and while we might pretend that we don't need that, it is nice to have people focus on you for a day, give you gifts, and you get to celebrate another year in the books, another year to take a look back, and another year to now look forward to what's coming up next. So number five is your birthday. Let's move on to number four.
Four.
So number four on our countdown is none other than your end of October spectacle that we know as Halloween. Halloween is a great day. You are allowed to be whoever you want on Halloween, or whatever you want. You see costumes ranging from celebrities to different sorts of objects to movie characters, fictitious TV show, people from the past, the present. And growing up, you get to go trick-or-treating. If you're older, you get to go trick-or-treating with maybe younger kids that, you know, are your own kids or relatives. You get to have costume parties if you're into that, where you hang around people who also have dressed up. It's really just a fun day in general. There is no real gift giving there. And, you know, sometimes the costumes can be expensive to spend money on, so that might bump it down a little bit in the list. But it's a great day. Everybody has fun, whether you're at work or at school. And, you know, you get, again, a lot of candy. Let's not forget about the candy here. The candy is huge in this. And everybody has their favorite types of candy. As long as you get some of your favorite candy on Halloween, I'm sure you're going to have a great day. So number four, Halloween. Let's get to number three.
Three.
For number three on our list this week, get your confetti ready. Get your poppers ready to go. It's New Year's, all right? So we go from 2017 to 2018, and you have a big celebration. You get, first of all, nobody has work or school on New Year's. That's a big part of that. The other 2 days that we've had so far, you might have work or school. You get to stay up late. You literally have to stay up till midnight. What are you doing if you're falling asleep before the ball drops, right? And that's a unique thing to New York. There's a big scene at Times Square. Personally, it's not my idea of fun to hang out in Times Square in a crowded area where you might have to wear diapers because you can't reach the bathroom. Let's get past that part of this. But New Year's overall, it's a fun day. Again, you're celebrating another year in the books. You get a chance at a new, fresh start, right? You have your New Year's resolutions. You get to be around your loved ones or your friends or people you care about and bring in the new year together. It's kind of a hopeful time and a time to be thankful for, you know, your health and your liveliness, and you get to celebrate a little bit. So hopefully New Year's is a good day for you. I tend to enjoy my New Year's every year. So let's get to number two before we get to number one. Number two, let's do it.
Two.
So number two on the countdown, I did struggle with because I at one point was thinking it could be number one, but number two this week, Independence Day, the 4th of July. First of all, what's great about Independence Day is that it's in the summer, right? We get good weather. If you're in New York, you know that that's a premium, as especially recently, we can't seem to get away from snow and rain. But it's good weather. Nobody has work or school that day, obviously. Barbecues are key. If you have a good celebration with a barbecue, you're with friends or family, you're going to have a good day. Sometimes maybe you're at the beach, you're hanging out on vacation somewhere. You know, it's really about getting the sunglasses on, getting bathing suits on, getting, you know, just some time to relax and enjoy yourselves at night. You can do fireworks. I may have forgotten to mention, you might see some fireworks for New Year's Eve as well, but 4th of July, I would say, is more synonymous with fireworks, and fireworks are awesome. I mean, things that explode, but as you saw with former Giants player Jason Pierre-Paul, don't get too close to the fireworks. As I say in tech class, we want everybody to start with as many fingers to start the day as when we end the day. So that's number two on the countdown, and that brings us to our dramatic finale. Here is your number one non-religious American holiday. No more waiting. Let's do it. One. And number one on the countdown is gobble gobble Thanksgiving. Now, I understand that this might come with a little bit of surprise for some. Why Thanksgiving as the best holiday? There's honestly a lot of reasons if you really divulge into it. I mean, first of all, we get to have a glorious meal. Let's be honest. It's probably one of the best meals you eat all year. You get turkey, you get gravy, you get stuffing, you get mashed potato, sweet potato, string beans, all sorts of amazing desserts and apple pies. And I could go on and on. Everybody has their own favorites, but that is a huge part of it. You get football with the family. Football is, you know, it's a huge American sport, but it's a unique thing on Thanksgiving to watch football with the people around you. Another thing, we get the day off of school and day off of work. And for most of us, we get that second day off school or work, and we're now turning that into a four-day weekend. Give me that. I'll sign up for that all day. Also, the day before Thanksgiving often leads to a lot of social gatherings. Thanksgiving Eve, as it's somewhat known as now, not to rival New Year's Eve from that standpoint, but that's a major day where people get together and they link up. A lot of times people who are home from college or coming home to see family, they're able to all hang out because they're now home together. So Thanksgiving, and then you think about the actual virtues of Thanksgiving. It's meant to appreciate what you have and that you will always have something more than someone else. So appreciate that. Be around your family and friends and think about how you can do better in the world for yourself, for your family, for your friends, but also for less fortunate. Can you donate to charity? Can you be more helpful to people in your community? What can you do to make a difference? Because there are people struggling in the world, and it's good to give back, and hopefully Thanksgiving reminds you of that. And with that, we have completed our first top five power rankings. With that said, I hope you liked the first installation of the Mascola Money Podcast. Each week, I will be releasing a new podcast on Wednesdays with a different power ranking for you to debate, for you to enjoy, for you to talk about amongst friends or family or whoever. Talk to me about it when you see me, and let's have a little argument if we disagree. But with that said, have a good one. This is Mascola signing off. Please make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel, What's Up Wednesdays, Suffern Middle School podcast, and also check out all the other great podcasts that the kids are putting out. They're doing great, and I want you to hear their stuff as well as mine. All right, everybody, have a great day, and I will see you soon.